Do not read PMBOK. Yes, you heard it right. Please do not read PMBOK if you really want to clear the PMP examination through a professional mindset and to make wonders happen around you. I suggest study properly. The study that brings in utter happiness, fun, and builds further interest in the subject while implementing the learning is a proper study. Then how to make it happen in the context of PMP examination? Here are the 7 aspects. 1. No mug-ups. 2. One process per day. 3. Identifying process taking place around you. 4. Random 5 to 7 questions per day. 5. Maximum 2 full-length mock tests. 6. Fundamental understanding of the PMBOK from someone who makes you understand how to study and does not teach. And 7. Most important, do not read PMBOK. One, no mug up. First and foremost thing is that do not mug up. One should aim for developing the conceptual clarity. The questions in the examinations are all practical situations. One should be able to relate them back to real life scenarios that one is going through. Mugging up leads to frustration, while conceptual clarity leads to fun and interest. Browse through one process per day. One and only one. Purpose, that is introduction of the process, output, inputs and tools and techniques is the sequence that is suggested for browsing. Further, ask and try answering following questions while browsing through each process. What is that I'll miss if I do not do this process? In which way this output serves the purpose of the process? Which part of the input is core for this process to happen? Why these tools and techniques are used? How they are different from each other? Too much content leads to frustration. Regular browsing of small chunks leads to fun and interest. Identifying process taking place around and mapping back to PMBOK. Shakespeare has said once that world is a stage. Someone who is preparing for the PMP examination must participate in at least as an audience. Watch the things happening around, in living room, in kitchen, in canteen, in conference room, in workplace, anywhere and everywhere. Try finding out the whole or a part of the process you have browsed in PMBOK taking place around. Later, you can start mapping the things happening around you to the PMBOK. The other day, I was sitting at a coffee shop and I overheard someone expressing the difficulties being faced in recruiting the needed resources. The discussion was happening on this table next to me. The person was chatting with his friend and was validating his idea about recommending 3% extra remuneration. Oh wow, look at that. This is what I mean by mapping back the things happening around you to PMBOK. Reading a process in a book leads to frustration. Playing hide and seek with the process is a real fun. Solving 5 to 7 questions daily. There are good websites where you get good set of questions. Select any 5 to 7 questions randomly. They must be random. Avoid selecting the questions from the process that you are reading. It creates pseudo-confidence. Each question adds to value to the topic. And hence, I would like to change the word question to scenario. So, solving 5 questions daily actually means you are practicing 5 scenarios and learning 5 topics per day. So, more number of questions lead to frustration. Rhythmic, regular, systematic practice is fun. 5th aspect, maximum 2 full-length mock tests. Maximum 2 full-length mock tests would be more than sufficient. That mainly develops the tenacity to sit through the 4-hour test. More number of full-length tests consumes time and generates fatigue and frustration. 2 tests are enough for body to get trained for required tenacity. It builds confidence and fun. 6th aspect, fundamental understanding. This is most important aspect. seek the fundamental understanding of the PMBOK from someone who does not teach and who makes you understand how to study and warns you how not to study. Take a guidance from someone who believes that PMBOK is a practical book and that PMP examination is a byproduct of the process of understanding. Teaching PMBOK leads to frustration. Learning how to study leads to fun. Do not read PMBOK, the most important one. Please do not read PMBOK. PMBOK is a recipe book. A good cook never reads the recipe book. A wise cook refers it. To refer means to seek help while doing. That means you will have to do it first and then you can refer. PMBOK is an artifact that one needs to refer before and even after the exam. One needs to refer a PMBOK because PMBOK is an action book, is a book that comprises best practices in project management. And hence, if I am facing an issue or about to face a problem, then I should refer PMBOK. I can find out some pathway to solutions, I can discuss it with some people and take the action. So, reading PMBOK leads to frustration. Making use of PMBOK leads to fun. These are the 7 aspects of proper study for PMP examination. 1. No mug-ups. 2. One process per day. 3. Identifying processes taking place around. 4. Random 5 to 7 questions per day. 5. 2 mock tests maximum. 6. Fundamental understanding of PMBOK from someone who makes you understand how to study and does not teach. And most important, never read PMBOK. Instead, refer to that. The study should be fun-filled. The study should create interest. And the study must be implemented. So let us conclude with the PM Oath. We are the project managers. We are proud of it. We shall never get attached to a project. We shall never hate ambiguity and chaos. We shall bring in predictability and visibility. We shall make life more simple, more beautiful, and more meaningful. Thank you.